This is a show. It is full escapism. No pun. But it really is an old school, an old fashioned sort of thriller. It's really well thought out. It's not, you know, there's no tropes. So what you think about hijacking, you just throw it out the window and put your seatbelt on. Oh, couldn't help myself. But it's going to be fun. It's really well done. And I'm not just saying that, but it really is. I keep saying, people, it's like the longest flight I've ever taken. It's like 6 months making a film about a 6-hour flight. There's an irony there, but it was a lot of fun making it. First of all, the idea of doing something that is just old school entertainment, but done in a way that no one's seen before. And a hijack, we've seen it all before, but doing this in a different way was really interesting. George Kay is a phenomenal writer, and I wanted to work with him, and I thought, here's the opportunity, so yeah.
Sure, Hijack is a 7-part thriller about when a passenger plane goes missing and gets hijacked mid-air. And Idris Elba's character, Sam Nelson, is one of the passengers. He's a business negotiator, tries to negotiate with the passengers. And I work with the authorities on the ground trying to rescue the passengers. It was wonderful. I mean, it was intense because there's so many characters and the stakes are very high and it gets progressively, more and more worrying, but it was highly enjoyable. There was a very nice energy on set, you know, set by Jim and Idris and George, and so everybody felt very comfortable. There were long hours filming in one room, either in the aircraft or on the floor, but it was highly enjoyable. We had a lot of fun as well when the cameras were switched off, which I think is necessary when you're doing a job like this. I think for the audience it's better because it adds that extra bit of suspense, the fact that you're watching what happens minute by minute. For the group on the ground, it was actually beneficial. A lot of our scenes were condensed down into a couple of weeks here and there, and so we got to do all our scenes and have a break, so it was a wonderful shoot. Well, it was my first time working with Apple. Very excited, classy company to work with, coupled with Idris Elba and George and Jim and a wonderful cast. It truly was a very, very enjoyable experience for me.
I can tease that it is a nail-biting roller coaster ride of a show. I know when I first read the script, I couldn't stop turning the pages. So if I feel like that reading it, I think the audience is going to feel the same. Well, it's sort of interesting as an actor because obviously you're going through one emotional journey, and so you have to really track that as you move through episodes and, you know, working with two different directors as well. So not only do they have to know where you are at any given time, you have to know where you are. Whereas, you know, usually if you're going from one point in time to the other, you can sort of skip to a different emotional point. But so that bit was quite challenging, but it also was really nice to only have to wear one outfit. Yeah, I mean, it's such a great cast. You know, I actually am not on the plane, but I think for the people on the plane, I imagine it began to feel quite real in terms of being in this confined space, which I believe was pretty much sealed once the camera was rolling. So I think when you get to work in an environment that feels real, I think that sort of brings some magic.
Well, if the audience hasn't seen it, it's basically a 7-hour thriller, a high-octane thriller, very suspenseful, and told in real time, of course, over 7 hours, involving a serious hijacking of a plane. And I'm on the ground, a cop that starts putting a few pieces together and working with the counter-terrorism team. And we, as things unfold, it becomes heavier and heavier and heavier, but it's great. That's it basically. If you like, it's event telly really, I've got to be honest with you, you know, and if you like serious drama and grab your seat, what's going to happen next, this is it. The rest of the cast, great. I didn't work with Idris for one day in 6 months because he was 30,000 feet up in the plane, and I was running around Whitehall chasing bad guys in cars and pulling out shooters all over the streets of London. Some of the greatest things for me, obviously, the stillness amidst the mayhem, but I also do like driving in high pursuit, and I do like having a little bit of fun. The stunt guys always love it when I'm on set because they know I can drive. However, the owners of the action vehicles do not, because I'm going to ruin their cars.
Lots of twists and turns, yeah, even in the pilot. I mean, that was why I wanted to do it so much in the first place, is that you just want to turn the page and find out what's going to happen next, which is, and they keep up that momentum for 7 hours, which is a testament to Jim and George. I mean, really fantastic. The craftsmanship of it is amazing. Wonderful. Amy Hubbard, who cast it, I think is brilliant at not only putting a talented team together, but also a really lovely group of people. So everyone was lovely. I mean, they normally say if there's one bad egg in the company and you don't know who it is, it's you. So it must be me in this scenario, because everyone was absolutely stunning and lovely and brilliant and at the top of their game. I mean, we've got some really fantastic people in this. Idris, obviously, but Neil Maskell, I think, is one of the best British actors working today, and he's phenomenal, and watching him work was, getting to watch him work every day was a real dream, actually. Longest flight of my life. Longest flight of my life. I can do a short flight now, a 2 hour flight, and it goes by like that. It was great. It was fun. We created a real community and gang, and you know, we really enjoyed it. Yes, it was claustrophobic, but that only added to what we were trying to achieve. You know, the less acting we had to do, the better. So, you know, the more claustrophobic and the hotter it got, the more we could just sit there and be in it rather than having to pretend.
Hijack is a high-octane thriller which all takes place on a plane and on the ground. It's kind of in real time. It's edge of your seat action. It's a really smart thriller. There's comic moments, there's strange moments, there's unexpected twists and turns. It's classic can't miss TV. I'm really excited to be here and see this thing made real. And it's just such a thrill, a real proper thriller. I couldn't put it down when I read the script. And I'm so excited to be here, even though I know what happens, no spoilers, but I can't wait to see it all unfold. It was such a great intense shoot, some great talent on board, fantastic writers, directors, producers, as well as the great cast, of course. Yeah, it's perfect TV. It's just a thrill to be here and be part of it. And such a joy to be like the captain of the plane, to pretend to be the captain of an Airbus. It was just great. It was like a sort of 9-year-old's dream for me to do that. It's a thrill. It's a thrill to be here. Amazing. It was very, very intense. But everybody was so great and so nice and so professional that working in that tiny fuselage for that long, it was just a dream. You know, you get to know people really well. You're sitting in that first class in the first class cabin, sitting there chatting with people, waiting for the take to happen. You know, it was intense. It was unlike any other shoot I've been, because it was one story day, one costume, one location for me and for a lot of others on that plane. So that was a real acting challenge in itself, to try and maintain that continuity over the length of the shoot, which was, you know, it was 2 or 3 months. It was intense. It was fun. The actors were fantastic. Idris was amazing leading the show. It was great fun to be sat in first class with Idris Elba for like 3 months. It was fantastic.
So exciting. It's so great to get everyone together, because the whole show is so split up with the plane and the ground team and everyone, and there's so many producers and cast and everyone. So to get everyone together for one celebration is fantastic. Yeah, so writing wise it's very kind of intense, because you're trying to tell a story all on one plane, which is kind of experimental challenge, and for the cast and the crew being trapped on one plane was almost like being hijacked themselves, you know, because it's just a full-on, intense 9-month shoot in one location. I got stuck on a train one day. The train stopped abruptly, and I was worried that there was some incident on board. And I thought, what would happen if that happened in real life? If it was much more serious than it was on the day I was traveling, and what would it be like if we put that 30,000 feet in the sky? I just hope that people relate to the situation. Not, of course, the hijack, but the actual. We've all been flying. We all know what it's like to travel, and so there's so many kind of everyday details in here that hopefully it'll force the audience to kind of wonder what they would do if they were stuck in a similar situation to the characters on board in the show. Yeah, we're always trying to like peel the onion back and create twists and turns along the way. So as each hour goes by, there's more story to unpack. Amazing. Well, we've just been so well supported by Apple. The whole team are amazing. Jay in London and the team in LA as well, supporting us right across the world, because these global streamers are really exciting to work for, and Apple's right up there as a leading streamer, so couldn't be more thrilled.
Well, it's truthfully, it's George Kay's inspiration, and as he's been saying, he was actually stuck on a Eurostar, and the lights went out, train stopped in the tunnel, and he started looking around the carriage thinking, who can help me out of this situation, who's going to make it worse? And that's where the kind of idea of it came from, and then it escalated into an idea set on a plane.
Yeah, it was one of those sort of one-page ideas that grabbed you straight away, and when they sort of pitched it to us, we were just like, we have to be a part of this. This is a brilliant opportunity to tell a very accessible story, but very intelligently. Really challenging. It was incredibly challenging. It was something we obviously going into the show knew that we were going to have to deal with, so we planned and sort of structured the whole of that shoot in a way that we tried to make that as bearable as we could for everyone involved, and try and work out a way to make it which wasn't going to be, you know, too arduous on our poor passengers that had the longest flight in the history.
It was the longest long haul flight of all time. Yeah. Sort of a 7 months on an aeroplane was hard work.
And the terrible truth of replicating a plane as accurately as possible is that you actually are on a plane for 7 months as a result of that. So,
I haven't been on a plane
since. No, I don't think we have, actually. No, yes, is the answer to that. Yes, we've managed to swerve planes since. Yeah, yeah. I'm quite looking forward to my next flight. Yeah.